Welcome to the fourth and final part. In this video, we are going to simplify the model, bake the color and normal map using the Reprojection tool, export the model and renders, use the animation tool, and finally upload the model to Sketchfab. Now I would like to share my model to Sketchfab, but it is too large. It has 16 million triangles and 1/16K texture. It is simply too large for uploading and viewing on Sketchfab with my basic account. The uploader has a built-in simplify tool, but I want to have more control over the simplification, so I will do it manually. To simplify the model, I will go to the Reconstruction tab and use the Simplify tool. I can use the absolute type or relative type. Absolute type simplifies the model to a selected number of triangles. The relative type simplifies to a chosen percentage of the original number of triangles. I usually use the absolute type. If I have 16 million triangles, the first target count is half of the original count, so 8 million. If I would use the relative type, I would use 50%. I will keep the reprojection disabled because I will do it later manually. To start, just click on Simplify. The simplification finished, so let's try to compare the original model with the simplified one. It is hard to see any difference in the model right now. It is possible to make renders of each model and compare them side by side, but I will show you how to do that later. I will repeat the simplification again, and this time the target count is 4 million triangles. You may get this warning sign, but I will ignore it now and check the topology at the later stage of the simplification. Now I will speed up the video until I get to 100,000 triangles. Now the lack of detail is being noticeable, but do not worry about that, I will use a normal map to fake the detail. Now I will check the topology last time, and everything is still okay. During the simplification, RealityCapture created multiple models, and I don't need them all, so I will delete a few of them. I will keep the original model 1 and rename it to Source. Model 2 can be deleted. I will keep the model 3 and rename it to High, as in High Polygon Count. I will delete all of the simplified models except the last one with 100K triangles and rename it to Low. To transfer the color texture and to create the normal map, I will use the Reprojection tool. The source model will be the one with the texture, and it is the High model. The result model is the low poly model. Supersampling all the way to 64, enable color reprojection, normal and displacement. I will not use the displacement map in this tutorial, but I can keep it. Now when I click on reproject, I will get this warning that the result model doesn't have UVs. They were lost during the simplification. This time I will choose no and unwrap the model manually. I am going to unwrap and I want to use one 4K texture for Sketchfab. So maximal resolution is 4K, the style is maximal texture count, and the count is 1. I will click on unwrap. The unwrap is done, so I will close everything and go back to the texture reprojection, and now I can start it. And it is done. Right away I can see the lower resolution of the texture, but it is still good enough for uploading to Sketchfab. This is the original one, and this is the 4K reprojected texture. All the processing is finished, and now I can continue with the exports. Here are some help articles on how to create the exports, but we will no longer use the help, so I can change the layout to 1+1, so I have a large 3D view. To export the model, go to the Workflow tab, Export Model, or go to the Reconstruction tab and also Export Model. I will use this one. I will create a new folder for my exports. RealityCapture supports multiple file formats, but I will keep the OBJ and click on Save. Until now, I was working in anonymous mode and now I have to log in. I will tap in my email address, password, and sign in. To acquire licenses, I need to tap in my PIN that I created in my profile on the capturingreality.com website. The licenses will cost me 864 credits, and this equals to roughly about $10. Now my inputs are licensed, and I can do as many exports as I want. Save mesh by parts is set to no, but it doesn't matter because my simplified model has only one part. The format is OBJ. I want to export vertex normals, I don't want to export vertex colors, and I also don't have any. I will change the number format to double to create a smaller sized file. For the texturing settings, yes, I want to export the textures, and I can keep the default settings. Color texture and normal map will be saved as PNG, and displacement map will be saved as EXR. Camera settings. I don't want cameras as model part. Next, export transformation settings. I will keep the grid plane coordinate system. There are some options to transform the scene or the normal map. We also have transformation presets, for example Blender and others. If I change the preset to Unreal, the scale changed and also the Y coordinate that corresponds to the green channel of the normal map is flipped. The Blender preset does not flip the Y coordinate. Okay, those were the export settings, and now I will click on OK. The model is exported, so now let's create some renders directly in Reality Capture. I forgot to close the texture reprojection tool, so I do it now. I will zoom to the head like this, switch to the original high poly model, and I will click export render. For the type, I will choose the colored textured, and I want 4K resolution. I will keep the shading to smooth. Color type set to texturing. I will change the default background color. I like this dark gray color. And to render the image, click on OK. I will create a new folder for the renders because I will be doing more of them. This is the high poly model. It is done. Notice the nice detail on the texture. Now I will do another render, but before I need to switch to the low poly model. Export render again and keep the same settings. Click OK and give the render a new name. This time it is the statue low. Now I can compare the two renders. Low poly on the right and the high poly on the left. There is a huge difference in the texture quality. Now let's try to create a video. I will switch to this layout. Change the right view to 3D and change the console to 4D. I will try to create a simple turntable animation. I will set up the view for the first frame and click on Add Keyframe, or I can use the Insert key on the keyboard. Notice that the playhead jumped 1 second on the timeline. Now I will change the camera angle and insert another keyframe. I will repeat this until I create a full circle around the statue. The camera path between each keyframe is interpolated to make a nice smooth path. This is the last keyframe. When I move the playhead, notice the camera motion in the right 3D view. Now I can use the playback button to play or pause the animation. I can select the entire animation and delete it, or edit the animation by dragging the keyframes on the timeline. But I liked it the way it was before, so I will bring the keyframes back. I can even jump between each keyframe. I can select each keyframe in the 3D view and change the camera position, rotation, or even projection parameters. The values can be changed in the 1D view or directly in the 3D view. When I was checking the animation, I noticed that the statue is out of frame on the last keyframe. I have to rotate it a bit to frame it, and now let's render the animation. Click on this icon. For the type, I can try something new and go with the composite 4 views. Keep the shading on smooth and coloring type on texturing. Full HD resolution, bitrate at the tutorial setting, and 30 frames per second. For the background color, I will pick a dark gray again. For the file type, I can choose Windows Media Video, MP4, or an image sequence in PNG or JPEG format. I will use MP4. I will create a new folder for the video and click Save to render it. The video has been created, so let's check it out in the Explorer and play it. This was the 4-view composite. Now you should be able to create some fly-through animations directly in Reality Capture. For the final part, I am going to export and upload the low-poly model to Sketchfab. To do this, go to the Workflow tab and over here is the Share button. Choose the first option, Share to Sketchfab. I need to accept the authorization request in the web browser. After accepting, I can now close the window and continue in Reality Capture. Here I can fill out the model name, add a description and tags, and I have 3 more options. I don't want to publish the model right after the upload because I want to play with the 3D settings first. I don't want to simplify the model because I already simplified it myself. And I want my web browser open after the upload. When you are ready, just click on upload. The model finished uploading, and now I can move it and rotate it directly in the web browser. Let's zoom on a model to check the quality of the texture. It's looking okay. What I can do further is to use the model inspector to view the base color without any lighting. This is the texture that was exported from RealityCapture. I didn't create a metalness map or roughness map, but RealityCapture created a normal map, and this is how it looks like. If we want to see what the normal map does, let's switch to matcap. This is the geometry without the normal map. It is missing a lot of detail from the original model. And this matcap is with the applied normal map. Let's take a closer look at the head. This is without the normal map, and this is with the normal map applied. Back to the final render. You can see that the basic setup already has some lights that create some nice shadows on the model. To change the background and to tweak the lighting and post-process effects, I will go to the 3D settings. I will start by rotating the model so the front of the statue is facing the camera. I will change the background to my favorite dark gray color. To change the lighting, click on the light bulb icon. I will start by changing the HDRI in the environment section. I can pick something with warmer colors like this, but right now I'm in the mood for something not so warm. This one, for example. I can change the rotation of the environment to change the lighting and the shadows on the model. Something like this. I also want to add some post-processing filters to make the render pop a little bit more. Turn on screen space reflections, SSAO, add a little bit of grain, no depth of field, add some sharpness and vignette that darkens the corners of the render. Let's rotate the model to take a look at it. When you are satisfied with your settings, it is time to compose the statue. You can go for a detail or go for an overall view of the statue like this. Once again, I will change the lighting a little bit. Now I'm satisfied and I will click on Save View. This will save the settings and create a thumbnail that will be displayed on my Sketchfab wall. And that's it. The model is ready for publishing. I would like to thank you for watching this tutorial. I hope you learned something new and are now prepared to use RealityCapture. See you in the next more advanced tutorial. Goodbye.